Okay, grasshoppers, origami ninja warriors in training, are you ready for your next assignment? It is the all-new Super Ninja Slingshot Arrow. With this weapon, you are invincible. That monster under the bed is toast. With this weapon, you can even slay a dragon. Grab your papers, grasshoppers. It's time to fold. Ichi, ni, san, chi. Let's go.
All right, so what's the secret for how to fold the ninja arrow? All you do is you take the arrow hook that I taught a couple weeks ago here, and you flatten it like this, and then fold it in half. And there you have the ninja arrow. And then you get your rubber band, and you fire. So I like how the ninja arrow shoots, but it's not a very easy model to fold, so I anticipate at least some of you are going to get really frustrated and comment, "Jeremy, you suck! I'm going to Rob's world!" So I experimented and tried to fold an easier model that still flies as well, and this is what I came up with, the Ninja Arrowhead. And it turns out that this little model shoots ridiculously better than the Ninja Arrow. And so this is what I'm going to teach you how to fold. Ready, set, here goes. All right, so for this model, I'm going to use a 6-inch square of kami. White side up, let's fold in half. And now unfold and rotate 90 degrees, and let's fold in half in this direction. Okay, now we're going to fold this edge up to the top and unfold. Okay, and now let's fold the edge to the middle crease. And now let's rotate and let's fold this edge, both layers, to right here. And rotate. And now we're going to fold, let's fold the half mark. Let's fold this edge to the crease. And rotate. And let's fold this edge to the same place right here. Okay, let's rotate. And now we're going to fold this edge, all layers, and we're going to fold it right to this crease. It's best if you can squeeze them together, that way they won't slip as much. And rotate 180 degrees, and let's do the same thing on this side. We're folding this edge right up to here. And squeeze them together, like squeeze them like this, and fold them up. Okay. Flatten it really well, and hate to say it, we're gonna do it one more time. So rotate, and let's fold this up to the middle, but first let's fold in half. Okay, and unfold, and now let's fold this edge to the middle, and rotate, and let's fold this edge to the middle. Okay, and flatten, 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 crease, crease, crease. And now we want to put one end inside the other. So, just pick a side, open it up, and take this and put it inside. So you want to just push it all the way in. And now wrap the edges around like this. and around like that. So it becomes a triangle. Okay, and really try to make sure that those edges are in there. And now we're going to press in on the thick edge of the triangle where we inserted the two ends. Push it in and squeeze it. And then just shape to taste. Squish to taste. There you go. Okay. And now I'm going to show you how to fly it. So get your rubber band and here we go.
Okay, guys. Now I'm going to show you how to shoot these with a rubber band. But know that these could hurt somebody pretty bad. I mean, especially this one. So just don't shoot it at anybody. Or any animal for that matter. Don't abuse this model. Don't misuse it. I mean, really, don't. Instead, just find yourself a target, a tree, a lamppost, a doorknob. For target practice today, I'm going to use an origami rainbow pyramid. All right, ready to learn how to fire this arrowhead? Here goes. First step, put a rubber band between your thumb and index finger. Now, let's turn this way. Notice that one band is closer and the other band is further away. If you pull the one that's closer and let go, it actually stings your fingers. Now, that's not good for firing because you want to really pull it back and you're going to hurt yourself. So instead, we're not going to pull this band. We are going to pull the one that's further away. So hold on to the middle of it and pull it and let go. And notice how it doesn't sting at all. Again, pull, boom. Now notice when you pull it back right here, these two bands are touching and these two. That's not good. Because when you actually want to fire the arrowhead, there's a good chance that it's going to hit this band and it'll mess up the flight. So instead, let's bring the band a little bit down, make sure that there's no twists in it, and we take the far band, we're going to lift it up and then pull it back. And that way, you see, there's a little space between these two bands and same on this side right here. So that way, it'll go right over this band. So here we go. All right, so wrap the arrowhead around the far band, lift up and back, and aim, and... just like that. Got it? And same with the arrow, you just put it on the far band and lift it up, pull it back like this, aim, and there it is. Aim and fire. Load, aim, and all right, so there you have it. Kids, don't misuse this model, really. I don't want anybody to get hurt. I don't want to be blamed for it. Just don't do it. Don't be stupid. It's a cool model. Have some fun with it. But don't hurt anybody, please. And if you have any questions, just let me know in the comments below. See you next time. Bye-bye. Yeah.